Let's do the same problem now. Show that the sum of two independent Poissons, one with mean 2 and one with mean 3, is another Poisson with mean 2 plus 3 equals 5. But now let's use moment generating functions. And with the theorems in chapter 7, the moment generating function approach is easier than what we did with convolution. So once again, x is Poisson with mean 2, y is Poisson with mean 3, and w is x plus y, where x and y are independent. That's just an assumption we're making of independence. You know, again, it's a modeling assumption. And with California and San Francisco, it's probably actually not the greatest assumption. I mean, they're kind of far away. Well, I mean, Los Angeles and San Francisco. They're kind of far away, like 5 hours drive time, but still they're both close to the San Andreas Fault. So the assumption of independence for Los Angeles and San Francisco is a bit dubious. However, if you compare Los Angeles to Tokyo, okay, then it's more reasonable. The independence assumption is an assumption about modeling that you hope is valid, and you often try to make it, use it if it seems reasonable, though you might want actual hard data to see if it seems reasonable, like are earthquakes in Los Angeles and Tokyo correlated at all? They're not in the San Andreas Fault, both of them, but they are in the same ring of fire around the Pacific Ocean. There's lots of earthquakes, I don't know if you know this, going up through California into Alaska, then down Russia into Japan and that kind of thing. There's a lot of earthquakes and volcanoes along that path. So seems more reasonable, but not completely unquestionably reasonable. Anyway, let's use the moment generating function approach based on, again, the fingerprint theorem and this theorem, chapter 7. X1 and x2 are independent random variables with known moment generating functions, and y is their sum. Then the moment generating function for y is the product, not the sum, the product of the moment generating functions for the variables that you're adding. So that would be true here. The moment generating function for w by independence is going to be, and since w is the sum, is going to be the product of the moment generating functions for x and y, look it up in the table. There's the moment generating function for a Poisson with mean k, kind of strange, exponentials within exponentials there. E to the k times e to the t minus 1 all is the power of e. Exponentials within exponentials. A bit strange, but that's what it is. K is 2 for x, so I get e to the 2 times e to the t minus 1. And k is 3 for y, so I get e to the 3 times e to the t minus 1. And then just simplify by adding the exponents. Maybe I should simple distribute the 2 through the first one first, and then the 3 through the second one second, and add those exponents, e to the 5 e to t, and then minus 5, and then you can factor out the 5. And then you say, hey, that is the moment generating function for a Poisson random variable with mean of 5. Therefore, by the fingerprint theorem, previous page, if two random variables have the same moment generating function for all t in some open interval around the origin, then they have the same distribution. You don't say they're the same random variable, because for a given situation, they could take on different values because of randomness. But you say they have the same distribution, which means they have the same PDF, the same CDF, the same mean, the same variance, etc. Fingerprint theorem. Now implies that w, which is the sum, is Poisson with mean 2 plus 3. In other words, Poisson would mean 5. Actually, I probably should have written those in the other order. It's Poisson with mean 5, and 5, hey, is 2 plus 3. So yes, I did add the means of the individual random variables. So yeah, once you've got the theorems in chapter 7, the moment generating function technique is easier. Though I will say, proving the fingerprint theorem is no piece of cake. The book doesn't even bother proving it at all, not even in the appendix. It's pretty advanced math to prove the fingerprint theorem. Proof is based on transform theory. Even just saying transform theory sounds scary, right? Transform theory. It's related to things like Laplace transforms and Fourier transforms. Essentially, the moment generating function is related to transforms, but I won't go into detail. We're happy to use the theorems without proving them.